Ladies and gentlemen, once again, it is time for the literary portion of our program, our Poet's Corner. It is with great pleasure and honor that I present our guest speaker of the evening. Here he is, the Poet Laureate of Abbey Rents, Professor Robert Louis Kirkwood.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Well,
yes.
Professor Kirkwood, how is it that you're always in such a happy mood?
Well, I owe it all to exercise, boy.
What kind of exercise, Professor?
Deep elbow bending.
Yes. Are you inferring that you drink to excess?
Oh, I'll drink to anything, boy.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm just full of the holiday spirit.
Yeah.
Get it, holiday spirit? Yeah. That was your late an eggnog.
I'm afraid it did, yeah. But, Professor, it is Christmas time, and I guess you're quite busy, though.
Yes, indeed. I'm busier than a beaver making a new coat for Liberace.
Is.
You see, boy, I have to write the poetry for all those Christmas cards.
Oh, you write the poetry for Christmas cards.
That's right.
Oh.
Yes, here's a special one I just made up for Jack Benny. Merry Christmas to you and a Happy New Year, too. These holiday greetings come postage due.
Very touching.
Yes. And he touched me for five when I delivered them. Brother, he's as tight as I'd like to be. Mm-hmm. Oh, here's one of my personalized cards.
Oh, thank you.
This year we won't buy a Christmas tree. It's money in our pocket. We'll just give Uncle Herman a couple of drinks and plug him in the socket.
Well, you do have a great talent, Professor.
Oh, yes.
Yes, it borders on genius. Just around the edge,
oh,
there.
Oh, yeah. Thank you very much.
I'm sure our poetry fans are interested in just what your schooling has been to achieve such genius.
Well, I studied 4 years at Harvard.
I can believe that.
4 years at Yale.
Yes.
And 1 week at Vassar.
What did you learn at Vassar?
That I'd been wasting my time at Harvard and Yale.
Have you been writing poetry long, Professor?
Oh, yes, for many, many years. But I'll never forget my first poem. It was called Ode to a Peppermint.
Ode to a Peppermint.
Yes.
That is off the path.
It told a very touching story.
Tell it.
It was about a one-fingered pickpocket who could only steal lifesavers.
In different flavors, I suppose?
No, made no difference.
Made no difference. Ah, well, that's very good. It must have been beautiful. Professor, you certainly loaded. Mm. That is, with talent, that is.
Then you're right both ways.
Well, right now, I think it's time to hear your poem. Oh. Would you mind carrying on, Professor?
Not at all. No. I call this poem Ode to a Loved One. Farewell, close friend of olden days. Your warm caress I'll not forget. You comforted me in many ways, but now, grown old, you seem all wet. The hours you nursed me as I lay in illness on my bed of pain serve not to make you less passé, and all is over and in vain. Too soon you aged while I stayed young, and though you gave your life to me, such sacrifice must go unsung. It's been thus through eternity. Your once firm body had to sag, give way, and wilt. Alas, too bad. This is goodbye. Old hot water bag, I'm getting an electric pad.